Hi folks, welcome to the Gredtron YouTube channel. This is Gredtron. We are doing Thin Lizzy Thursday, the show where I react to Thin Lizzy songs. I know the catalog very well, but to make things exciting and interesting for me, and give it that sort of genuine reaction flavor, I don't actually choose the songs that I'm reacting to. It's randomly chosen by a random number generator. And usually, you see me react to the random number generator live in the reaction. But the song I got this week is really awesome, and there's a video for it, and the video reaction might not actually get blocked on YouTube, so I'm like, oh shoot, I should react to the video. And it took me a while to get that set up, and I realized that is super boring, so I cut out all that, just to make it easier for you folks. You don't have to endure the boringness. But we are reacting to Old Town, Phil Lynott's second solo album. This is a top-tier song, a masterpiece in the catalog, just something I'm really excited to get into. We have, you know, two great heavy hitters in a row. Freedom Song, followed by this. Yeah, this is, you know, a very awesome, unexpected treat. And my intro for the last video, which I ended up deleting, was saying, like, oh, what if I get one of my favorite songs ever this week? Wouldn't that be cool? And, I mean, this is a fine, fine song. Got the video pulled up, so let's enjoy this together. It's quite a bit different than Thin Lizzy in terms of the instrumentation used, but I don't feel like, how do I put it? So just because it's a more piano-driven song, I don't think the melodies or vocal approach or even lyrical approach is that far removed from Lizzy. And I think if you put this on a Lizzy album, it would still fit in, even though it's like, you know, a piano-driven piece. I think it still would work as a Lizzy song, even though it's a Phil Lynott solo song. As a guy who really likes the Beatles, I'm okay with bands having, like, songs sounding vastly different from each other on the same album. As a guy who loves the White Album, I'm like, yeah, man, do whatever you want. That's cool. But for me, this fits in with Phil's general songwriting motifs very well, and so a lot of people are like, wow, it's so different, but for me it fits like a glove right in. So yeah, let's get into Old Town.
The girl's a fool, she broke the rules, she heard a lie. This time and so she bust all that's lost. The system has broke down. Romance has broke down. This boy is cracking up. This boy has broke down. She plays it hard, she plays it tough. But that's enough, the love is over. She's broke his heart and that is rough. But in the end, you'll soon recover. The romance is over. This boy is cracking up. This boy has broken down. This boy is cracking up. This boy has broken down.
Yeah, so ordinarily, for my reactions, I do, like, a lot of the pauses and comment on what I'm hearing. And I think I was just so into it that I was like, oh shoot, I haven't said anything. Got the lyrics pulled up in another tab, so let's take a look at these bad boys. The old Covent Garden, I remember only too well. The girl's a fool, she broke the rule, she hurt him hard. This time you will break down. She's lost his trust, and so she must. All is lost, the system has broke down. Romance has broke down. This boy is cracking up. This boy has broke down. She plays it hard, she plays it tough. But that's enough, the love is over. She broke his heart, and that is rough. But in the end, you'll soon recover. The romance is over. This boy is cracking up. This boy has broken down. This boy is cracking up. This boy has broke down. So, you know, hearing the line, this boy, over and over again, like, reading it like this is reminding me of This Boy by the Beatles, just giving me that nostalgic throwback. And even though at this point, you know, Phil is, what, in his, he's in his, you know, 30s at this point. What year is this? Maybe he's in his 40s at this point. But still, the, actually, no, how old was Phil Lynott during this era? Because, what, he was 36 when he died? Yeah, so he was 36 when he died. So, and this was... this was 82. Okay, so, you know, in his 30s. And then still referring to yourself as a boy. But I think that, like, you know, that eternal youthful optimism... not even youthful optimism, but, like, youthful vulnerability. Like, being able to, you know, because a lot of, like, rock musicians wouldn't call themselves a boy. Like, I'm a man. Ooh, Disturbed. I'm so tough. But the vulnerability and sort of, like, the eternal youth that you get with, like, referring to yourself as a boy or the character as a boy, you know, helps keep that youthful spirit, even though this song is very, mature in terms of, like, the instrumentation. And when you look at the videos, like, you know, they're all dressing, you know, very nice and proper, but still stylish. Like, Phil looks very cool in the video. But, you know, it's a song that has, like, sort of, like, a mature anguish, but still, like, a youthful beauty to it, which is great. And then musically, I believe, what, this is a Jimmy Bain, Phil Lynott co-write, if I'm remembering correctly. Was this Jimmy Bain? Yeah, so Jimmy Bain co-write with Phil Lynott. And then, I believe, is... I think this is Darren Warden on the keyboards, if I'm remembering correctly. Yeah, so he's keyboards on this track. And I think his keyboards are a phenomenal fit for the song. In many ways, I've said, like, his keyboards didn't fit in on Thin Lizzy songs, on certain Thin Lizzy songs, but they work so well here. And there's a fantastic piano solo that we're going to get into by Darren that works. I just love the vibe of this one. It's just, you know, great synthesizer tones, great piano tones, excellent vocal performance, great melody, a good driving drum beat. And it shows that, like, you don't necessarily need, rock and guitars for a driving, energetic song that carries you on an emotional journey. So yeah, I'm going to rewind just a hair and, take a moment to appreciate, Phil's pouty face, and yeah, we'll get back to it. Yeah, just incredibly beautiful piano solo right there. Just well played, well composed, you know, melodically builds in all the places that you want it to. Fantastic. And then, you know, you watch that sequence. It's like traveling in a time machine back to a time before I existed. And just, it gives you that very, like, European 80s vibe. European metropolitan vibe, which, like, as someone who, like, watches, like, old Sherlock Holmes TV films from the 80s, like, it has a certain feel to it. Just the way the cameras look, the haircuts, the styles, it just gives you a certain vibe to it that isn't necessarily... I'm trying to think of it. It's not necessarily consumed a lot by, like, you know, millennials. But I think that kind of stuff is just cool. Just it's an atmosphere that I dig. And it's cool to see, like, you know, Phil walking through the streets and, like, you know, him, you know, garnering some attention, like, because he's, you know, a hero in the old town, you know, Dublin, hometown hero. Everyone wants to say hi, wave to him. Because the song is about, like, ultimately, like, the mixed emotions one can have when visiting the old town, and, like, the feelings, the feels that you get when going to the old town. And, you know, very, very beautiful looking Irish pub here. Let's get to this Nets part. Oh, and that kiss. Super cute.
I've been spending my money in the old town. It's not the same, honey, when you're not around. I've been spending my time in the old town. I sure miss you, honey, now you're not around. Now you're not around this old town.
I mean, freaking iconic, brilliant. Just, you know, how freaking just, you know, Irish is this? Like, the lone poet sitting alone at a pub, pining over past love. Mwah. Chef's kiss, magnifique, Phil, magnifique. Ah, just so freaking great. All right, let's rewind a hair. Ah, great drum fill. Hola. Great, you know, I call it iconic, even though this isn't necessarily considered like a legendary music video by most folks, but just, you know, it just feels iconic. It's the kind of thing that, like, you just wonder why it wasn't bigger than it was. So I do really like, you know, the trumpet solo, which is, I guarantee you, Phil did not play on the recording, and that he just did it for the video because it looked cool. But it's, I do like how it goes from, like, this real low point at the pub, and then you rise up with Phil's sort of, like, you know, optimism, like, the way when, you know, you look at, like, the facial expression of the woman in the video, and it's, like, it's very, like, dour and stoic, but Phil is, like, smiling and being playful, and that causes her to smile, and it's sort of like when you have, in relationships, when you have, like, a falling out with someone, and, you know, humor being the thing that, like, you know, breaks that tension and get things back to a more positive place, it's sort of like an abstract version of that within the video, which is cool. And so it starts to crescendo into this optimistic place, but then ends on this bittersweet, melancholic note as he walks alone, towards the ocean. So, I mean, that is, absolutely, absolutely fantastic. Let's take a look at the rest of the lyrics. I've been spending my money in the old town. It's not the same, honey, when you're not around. I've been spending my money in the old town. I sure miss you, honey, now that you're not around. Now that you're not around this old town. Hola, hola, this boy is cracking up. This boy has broken down. This boy is cracking up. This boy has broke down. Yeah, so, freaking love this song. It is a, yeah, Stone Cold classic masterpiece. And now comes the, you know, the tricky part as to where we rank this bad boy. Let's see here. Old Town. Yep, this is a quadruple S rank. Gonna go below Waiting for an Alibi, but I'm moving some stuff around. I'm actually, here is how I'm feeling this week. Here is how I'm feeling this week once my computer loads. As you can see, Greg's computer not the fastest, but actually, I'm going to bump up Old Town above A Night in the Life of a Blues Singer, and actually move in Waiting for an Alibi up too. We have switched up the ranking, boys and girls, that's right. So, for first-time viewers, we'll go from the bottom. We haven't had any D's or F's, but we got the C-rank category right there. B-rank above that. A-rank. S-rank. Double S-rank. Triple S-rank. And quadruple S-rank, the best of the best. Yeah, for me, Old Town is one of the best of the best of the best, sir, to quote Men in Black. Yeah, it's just pure emotion in a song. It's poignant, it's melodic, it just tugs at the feels. It's just one of those great, like, pining for lost love songs and just capture this bittersweet, melancholic atmosphere so well. But it's not like a... It's not a pity party, though. It's not just like, oh, woe is me, but it's just like, just sorting out the feels. And the video is great. So, yeah, Old Town, fantastic. I love it. Do you love it? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to do the liking, commenting, subscribing, and, yeah, stick around for more Thin Lizzy Thursday. Bye, everyone.